You're gonna drive in your opponent, and then you're gonna snap them down. This time we're gonna ankle pick from the front headlock. Okay? So, make contact with my opponent. He makes contact with me. Overtie, I mean, thumb lock here. Drive forward. He holds pressure. I snap him down underneath me. I get into my front headlock position. And then I'm gonna ankle pick, same side leg as the hand that has his bicep, the hand that has his arm. This hand's gonna ankle pick this ankle. Okay? I like this move a lot. I'm always surprised kind of when it works because I don't know, I just feel like how can somebody let you go from this position to the back of your ankle? It's like, why wouldn't they just throw it back? But for some reason, a lot of guys don't throw their ankle back and people score this. So it's good technique. So we got our guy in our front headlock, he's in his quad pod. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drop down to the knee that's closest to that foot, okay? I'm gonna drop down to the knee that's closest to that foot, and I'm gonna take his head, and I'm gonna try and make it kiss his knee. All right, I'm gonna take his head, I'm gonna drive it to his knee. So I'm here, I drop down to my knee that's closest to his foot, I take his head to his knee. Now I release my hand to the back of his ankle, and I use my forearm and my shoulder to throw him over top. All right, put him on his butt. And then I come up to my feet. So as I use my shoulder, my forearm to throw him over top, I'm pulling at his ankle with my hand, pulling it back to my chest. So contact, drive, he pressures into me. I snap him down. Now, I'm gonna take everything, knee down to the mat, head down to his knee, hand to the back of his ankle. Kind of crunch him up in this position. Then I'm gonna use my shoulder, my forearm, throw him over top. As I pull his ankle off underneath him and come up to my feet. So that finish is what would happen in a perfect world. If he hit the move perfectly, I mean, if he hit the move, guy just falls down. A lot of times what happens is I get to this angle, the guy's head pops up, and I switch to a double. All right, or a high crotch, either one of these. So that's usually what happens, and then I come up to my feet, run across and finish. So you guys can drill either one of those. But just getting to the ankle is the important part. From there, you should have a pretty easy time finishing, because even if the guy brings his head up, he's not in a good position to sprawl. You get both of his legs and finish quickly. So again, I got him underneath me. This is the foot that I want. I'm gonna take my hand to the back of it, drop down to my knee, throw away his head, come up to my feet. If that foot's back, and I still want it, so put that foot backwards, and I still want that foot, I mean, what we have to do is drive him forward and circle, right? So if I want that foot and it's back, I drive him forward, I circle, now it's out in front of me. Take his head to his knee, kind of crunch him up, throw him over, land on your feet. One thing I don't want to see is when you go to his ankle, you fall down with him. Right? Because now this guy can sit the corner. He can do a whole bunch of things. It's going to make it way more difficult for you to finish the shot. So either throw him over top or release his head into your double. Any questions? You guys good to go?
Yep.
All right, let's try it. 1, 2.